Good morning students, in this video we will discuss another eubacteria, that is mycoplasma. Mycoplasma has only cell membrane, cell wall is absent. The cell membrane has three layers. Once it is called trilamellar structure, this is trilamellar structure, and it is totally prokaryotic in nature. In prokaryotic nature, the true nucleus is absent. Nucleus-like structure present, that is called the incipient nucleus. In the protoplasm, there are some important structures. They are called elementary bodies. In mycoplasma, reproduction by means of elementary bodies and some enzymes, proteins, and single-strand DNA, 70S type of ribosome is also present. This is the cell structure of mycoplasma. Mycoplasma is also one of the important eubacteria. In the mycoplasma, this is the protoplasm of mycoplasma contains both DNA and RNA. DNA is a double-stranded and RNA is single-stranded. And they are some of the elementary particles. In mycoplasma, reproduction by means of elementary particles. So there are some enzymes present, proteins present, there are another particles also present. This mycoplasma was discovered by, Nocard and Rocks in cattles which are suffering from pneumonia. Which are suffering from pneumonia, and these mycoplasma, they are highly pleomorphic. Mycoplasma highly pleomorphic, hence they are called PPLO, or they are also called jokers of plant kingdom. They are also called jokers of plant kingdom. Mycoplasma also called PPLO, pleuropneumonia like organisms, or jokers of plant kingdom. Mycoplasma are the smallest prokaryotic organisms. This point is very important. They are the smallest prokaryotic organisms. Usually cell wall is absent. They can survive even in the absence of oxygen. They can infect, they can cause diseases in both plants and animals. And due to absence of cell wall, mycoplasma are insensitive. They are insensitive to penicillin, but they are sensitive to streptomycin and other antibiotics. So they are the smallest prokaryotic organisms which can diseases in both plants and animals. So these are the some of the important eubacteria. Eubacteria has several subgroups, but in this chapter we will discuss about only cyanobacteria and mycoplasma. It's on the basis of shape. Bacteria is of four types: Coccus, they are spherical bacteria, monococcus, sometimes diplococcus, sometimes tetracoccus, they are different types of bacteria. Next, bacillus. So bacillus, they are rod shaped bacteria. Next, spirillum. These bacteria are helically twisted. So they have number of, at the end, this bacteria possesses large number of flagella. Next, Vibrio. They are comma shaped. Vibrio cholera. Cholera poison bacteria is called Vibrio cholera. It is comma shaped. So these are the different types of bacteria. They are classified on the basis of their shape. Mainly four types: Coccus, Bacillus, helical, sorry, spiral element vibrio. And next one is another important topic is based on Gram's stain. Bacteria is of two types. Based on Gram's staining, bacteria can be classified into two types: Gram positive, Gram negative. And how we can differentiate this is Gram positive and this is Gram negative bacteria? Christian Gram developed a technique for staining of bacteria, and this procedure or this technique is known as Gram staining. And initially he heat bacterial smear heat and fixed on glass slide. Then this glass slide, it is dipped into crystal violet. It is dipped in crystal violet. Then all bacteria, they pick up the purple coloration. After that, this glass slide which is pick up purple coloration, it is dipped in 0.5% iodine solution, and after that it is again dipped into acetone or alcohol. After that it is washed into pure water. So after washing, if any bacteria they retain blue or purple color, they are called Gram positive bacteria. If they lose color, they are called Gram negative bacteria. So this is the procedure of Gram staining. Then we can differentiate some of the bacteria are Gram positive and some of the bacteria are Gram negative. The Gram positive bacteria, some of the Gram positive bacteria are Bacillus, Rhodomonas, Pseudomonas. So these are the some examples for Gram positive. Next, Escherichia coli, Vibrio cholera. So these are the some of the Gram negative bacteria. And what is the main difference between Gram positive and Gram negative? Techoic acid present on cell wall of Gram positive bacteria and techoic acid on cell wall of Gram negative bacteria. Gram positive bacteria cell wall has only one layer. Gram negative bacteria has two layers. So these are the two important differences between Gram positive and Gram negative bacteria. So these are the some of the extra important points from the kingdom Monera.